Gotera, professor at the University of Denver, Graduate School of Social Work.
Hi, I'm Suzanne Pritzker, an associate professor at the University of Houston, Graduate College of Social Work.
And I'm Denise Moreno, a research associate at the University of Houston, Graduate College of Social Work.
The three of us have been working on a research project alongside community partners and a group of Latinx youth co-researchers to explore the question of how to promote civic engagement among Latinx youth through the voices of those youth. This work was designed to have public impact, to inform communities and organizations on ways to increase the civic engagement of Latinx youth. It's important all the time. In this moment of a major election upon us, it's even more important. So we're excited to share this with you today.
This work is grounded in a community-based participatory research method that involved a group of 16 youth experts, 8 each from Denver and Houston, as part of the research team. The youth experts on this team guided this project, collecting data, analyzing data, and interpreting findings, including those that we're presenting in this video. The purpose of this study was to explore Latinx youth perspectives on 4 research questions. We wanted to understand what is civic engagement through the eyes of Latinx youth, what facilitates, what makes civic engagement easier, what are things that make civic engagement harder and get in the way, and then what are practical strategies, specific strategies in response to those facilitators and barriers that can help encourage Latinx youth civic engagement. What are specific strategies that schools, organizations, peers can adopt in order to help increase engagement among Latinx youth? This research and our findings that we're presenting today are grounded in the voices of 108 Latinx youth from both Denver and Houston who participated in focus groups led by our youth expert team.
Latinx youth identify common themes across contexts, suggesting the need for multi-level strategies that work across the distinct contexts of young people's lives. Strategies include accessible, culturally grounded information targeted at both youth and their families, positive messaging and modeling, safe space for discussion and participation, youth-led spaces, and reducing barriers for participation. Next are 2 of our youth experts team members, Catherine Avila speaking about family strategies and Alexis Ruiz speaking about economic and political context strategies. They will give us their takeaways and why they matter.
Hi, my name is Catherine Avila. I graduated Travis High School located in Southeast Houston in 2018. And today I am a rising junior at Wellesley College. I became part of this research project my senior year of high school. I remember seeing posts around campus of the Young Emerging Leaders First meeting. I attended, and that later got me participating in different events around my school and eventually prior to this project. This project really hits home because, I mean, listening to the students in the focus groups, I noticed that there were a lot of similarities in their answers and the answers I had for myself. There's even memes about how our parents tend to be very similar. They tend to fall under the more strict side. There was always these questions in the back of my mind when it came to me wanting to get involved in a school activity, such as, will I have permission to go? Will my parents be able to give me those $10 to $15 to join a certain thing? Will my mom be able to take me? And sometimes these thoughts stopped me from attending or taking that next step, which I strongly believe that focusing on applying these family-focused strategies can help us support Latinx youth civic engagement. And today I will be telling you my 3 takeaways from the family-focused strategies. So for the first one, we constantly heard throughout the focus groups that their parents not knowing what was going on was a huge barrier in their engagement. So I think a major one would be to provide simplified and accessible information for parents, in Spanish for parents, to be able to make them feel included. And I know at least for my mom, she feels more comfortable when she calls somewhere and she asks, do you speak Spanish? And if they say yes, it's a huge relief, sigh of relief for both of us. And for me, it's just because I will have to translate. And sometimes that can be nerve-wracking for me. So with this, I think that we can provide information in places such as Facebook or WhatsApp, and create like a community, you know, group chat, where it could be a place where parents can talk to each other or have conversations with the youth too. It is hard for the youth to talk and to speak to and sometimes against their parents about certain topics. As for many of us, speaking for ourselves is found to be disrespectful. So I believe that encouraging these conversations at home is a great first step to get the parents aware. My second one is to provide ways in which their children can be praised for being civically engaged. This means make youth civic engagement viewed more positively rather than something dangerous or rebel-like. And this is to help parents see that their children have a voice and are able to make changes with it. And this could be done if we do move to like a Facebook group, creating a community-based account where different students could get praised if they were active and participating in civic activities. I do think like parents love attending their kids' show awards or sports awards, sport events. And I think that this would be a great idea if we move it to something online. And my last takeaway is to provide ways in which parents have access to be involved. This could be done with fundraisers or with carpooling if possible. This is benefiting because I've noticed that there are more parents actively engaged in their children's lives or school when they are in elementary school, which it's probably for the obvious reasons, but I think this can be gained again if approached and invited to help. This could be done by making PTOs more active or by giving them attention and funding. And I think it's really important to, you know, have parents involved because that is a great first step to help the youth civic engagement improve. But yeah, these are my three takeaways for our family-focused strategies. Thank you.
Hey there again. This is the second part, or the second topic I'm going to be touching on today, which is the economic and political context that goes into civic engagement. So I remember, oftentimes a lot of youth don't get involved in civic engagement due to economic reasons that stop them. And besides the fear that especially Latino parents have for their youth in getting civically engaged, I think oftentimes when I would always talk to my high school friends about why they wouldn't get involved, a lot of it has to do with money and transportation. So I think what we could do is create clubs for each high school in which they could get funding to provide them food, you know, it's at no cost, and they can eat and have transportation. Those are the two main things that hinder, you know, food is already enough of an incentive. Well, free food is enough of an incentive. And then if they have transportation to get home and to wherever they need to be, then that's another plus, because a lot of times, you know, parents work long hours and they don't want to drive after, you know, another whole hour to go pick up their children, you know, after working a long day. So that'll definitely create more access and allow more youth to get involved. And also providing financial incentives for youth to get involved. I remember, you know, when I first heard about this research, I was already the incentive of being around a doctor and being around scholars and being around other intelligent people was already enough of incentive to me. But when I saw those Amazon gift cards like coming my way, I was like, okay, it's pretty cool that I see my work coming back to me. So I think by, you know, knocking down those big barriers of terms of transportation and money and providing spaces where you can talk about these things is going to be a big way that we can actually start creating change and allowing us to take youth seriously and allowing them to foster and grow and change the current situation that we're living in. So yeah, I really appreciate you guys for your time, and I appreciate you for listening to me. I hope that we can all see each other again after this whole pandemic. But yeah, I really hope that y'all have a good one.